As you can see, our kids are here and they're getting ready to sing. So this is, again, it's our first Christmas cantata, church and school together. I want to thank Gabriela McNeil, the music teacher for the school, for the kids. I also want to thank you to our principal, Vernice, and Mrs. Florence as well, and all staff and volunteers involved to make this possible. And our praise team, our church, is putting all of this together. So I'd like to say a prayer right now and surrender this into our hand, into the Lord's hands. Father, in the name of Jesus, we pray. You bless this cantata right now. May your name be glorified. Jesus' name be uplifted. And may he today be born into somebody's heart. In Jesus' name, amen. So on behalf of the Baltimore White Marsh Seventh-day Adventist Church and School, we want to welcome and thank each and every one of you for being here today for our first joint church and school cantata. Your presence today means a lot to us as church, but it means a lot to our kids. We truly appreciate all the effort put behind to make this possible. Perhaps today, again, is your first time here at our church, and I'd like to ask you a little favor. As we contemplate on the events that surrounded the birth of Jesus on earth, I'd like to ask you to keep an open mind and an open heart, because what we're about to find out is that even though Jesus was born well over 2,000 years ago, he can still be born into our hearts today. And if you allow him to be born into your hearts today, your life is about to become a whole lot like Christmas. Amen. The song you just heard, if you had a hard time understanding that, it's not your fault. They sang in Latin. The song is Stolite Hostias, and it means, bring forth your offerings, and adore the Lord your God, and worship him in his holy place. Rejoice in heaven. Exalt people on earth, for the Lord now comes in glory. Hallelujah. And the song you're about to hear now is, what you gonna call this baby? In those days, name picking was something a little more than what it means today. In those days, the name picking was like an answer to prayers. The names were chosen under the circumstances of the birth or the parents' hopes for the child's life. For instance, the name Isaac. Isaac means laughter. Abraham and Sarah cried for many years for not being able to conceive a child of their own. When Sarah heard that she was about to conceive and become pregnant at 90 years old of age, she couldn't help but laugh. Her first laughter was a laughter with skepticism. But when she held Isaac in her arms and she saw him smiling at her, her laughter now was of joy. Take another name, Samuel. Hannah, his mother, went to the temple often to pray and ask God to bless her with a child. For years, she was barren. She could not conceive a child of her own. One day, God answered her prayers, and she named him Samuel. Samuel means, God heard my prayers. So, with Mary, different. When the angel Gabriel appeared to her and told her she was going to conceive, she asked, how is that possible if I'm a virgin? Now, she wasn't doubting. She was just curious. How is that even possible? The same God who made a barren and elderly woman get pregnant is the same God who can make a virgin conceive. But this time, it wasn't the mother who picked the name. This time, it was God. The angel told her, you shall call him Jesus. And guess what Jesus means? God is salvation. It's going to be sung by the 3rd and 7th graders, and it's called Sing Noel. On that night when Jesus was born, angels came to announce the birth of Jesus to shepherds on the field. Today we hear the story, we see kids playing roles of shepherds, and we find that cute and interesting. But we're missing one big part. Being a shepherd in those days, it was not a good thing. You only became a shepherd if you failed at everything else. Becoming a shepherd was your last resort in life. Despite of being necessary, shepherds were not appreciated, were never praised in private or public, and often they were ostracized. They smelled like sheep all the time. So when heaven's angels choir appears to them, God was making a statement. My son, Jesus, the Savior of the world, is for all people, from the smallest to the greatest, from the poorest to the richest. According to human standards, the choir of angels sang before an audience of a handful good-for-nothing misfits, smelly shepherds. But according to heavenly standards, the angels did not sing before the shepherds. The angels sang before the King of Kings and the Lord of Lords, Jesus Christ. Wouldn't you want to join the angels singing on that night to a King who is for all people, for all races, for all classes? Would you not want to join the angels singing to God who bring us all together? No male, nor female, no master, nor servant, no Jew, nor Gentile, no black, no white. We all one in Jesus Christ.
Amen.
I would do everything to join the angels on that day. But we can do it today. Sing Noel. The next song we are about to listen and hear is Mary, Did You Know? It will be performed by our praise team and our adults. Mary knew she was expecting the Son of God in her womb, she was told. But little did she know what he was going to do. If Jesus had only come to save us from our sins, which he did, he could have showed up on that Friday night at 33 years old of age, on that Friday evening, died on that Friday only 3 hours later, be resurrected on Sunday morning, and he would be gone up to heaven. He could have done that. But why did God choose to send his son as a baby? Why would he choose him to spend 33 years of his life here on earth? Yes, Jesus came to die and save us for our sins, to give us an everlasting life. But he also came so we can have hope for today. Not only hope in the future, but we can have hope for today. Jesus came. Not only we can have everlasting life, but every day of our lives, we can have abundant life. Maybe you're struggling in life. Maybe you're dealing with issues that you judge him hopeless. Maybe you think that God on earth or God in heaven is too busy to care for you on earth. I wanted to hear the words of Mary, Did You Know? And be sure that the same Jesus who did all those things on earth can still do it for you today. Mary, Did You Know? Thank you. The next two songs we are about to hear, the first one is Born in Bethlehem. It will be performed by our K and second graders. And the second one would be On This Silent, Peaceful Night, performed by the third and seventh graders. In the times of Jesus, the little town of Bethlehem was not an important place. Just one little town in one little corner of Israel where nothing really important happened until that night. The interesting thing, however, I must say, is that this little town of Bethlehem received its name about 1,000 years earlier. And the little town of Bethlehem, guess what Bethlehem means? In Hebrew, means house of bread. What a joy to know that Jesus, the bread of life, will be born into the little city called Bethlehem.
Thank you.
The next two songs we're about to hear is, the first one is Who Would Imagine a King? It'll be performed by our K and second graders. The next one will be sang by the adults. It's called Emmanuel. But who would have thought, who would have imagined a king? Jesus, the Son of God, came as a baby. He was born in a stable, laid in a manger, grew up in a carpenter in a bad town, hung on a cross as a criminal, buried in a grave, but was resurrected as King of Kings and Lord of Lords and as our God. If there's one thing that the Bible teaches about the birth of Jesus, it's to never underestimate humble beginnings. To never underestimate underdogs. You may not have been born in a wealthy family, a family of a name here on earth, but you are a son and a daughter of the living God. Amen. It doesn't matter where we came from, it does matter where we are headed. Amen.
Thank you.
Silent night, holy night. All is calm, all is bright. The reality is that there are times in our lives in which everything seems everything but calm, seems everything but bright. Yet, the word of God in Philippians 4:7 says, the Lord is at hand. Do not be anxious about anything, but in everything by prayer and supplication, with thanksgiving, let your requests be made known to God. And verse 7 says, and the peace of God, which surpasses all understanding, will guard your hearts and your minds in Christ Jesus. Do you want to have that peace that surpasses all understanding? You may not be able to stop the storms of your life, but you can learn how to trust in the midst of the storm. You may not be able to hear the voice of God in the storm, but you may learn to know that He's there, even when you can't hear Him. Today you heard about the birth of Jesus, but I pray you will consider allowing Jesus to be born into your heart once again. Or maybe if He has not been born into your heart, it is only when Jesus is born into our hearts and He grows and develops and takes more room and continues to grow. Only when Jesus is in our hearts, not in a manger anymore, is when we learn how to have this peace that surpasses all understanding. And then we can indeed sing, silent night, holy night, all is calm, all is bright.
Thank you.
There's one thing usually the world forgets to see about this time of the year, Christmas time. It is true that Jesus indeed came as a baby. He was laid in a manger as a helpless babe. But that story does not end there. In John chapter 14, Jesus makes one of the most powerful promises than anyone could have ever made. John 14, 1 says this, "Let not your heart be troubled. Believe in God, believe also in me. In my Father's house are rooms. If it were not so, would I have told you? I would not have told you so. And I go and prepare a place for you. And if I go and prepare a place for you, I will come again and will take you to myself. And where I am, you may be also." It's a powerful promise. It's a powerful promise. And as we're closing our Christmas cantata, I'd like to let you know this. Some of you know that I'm a former atheist. For years of my life, I stopped believing God completely in the very existence of God. But if you really, really give the Bible a chance and God a chance, I highly recommend you to really study for yourself and find for yourself. Don't take my word for granted. Don't take anyone's words for granted. But do your research and you find out that God is real and He's alive. And if Jesus came on earth on the very first time, and all the prophecies pointed that He was going to come as a baby, He was going to grow as a man, He was going to hang on the cross, He was going to die, be buried, and be resurrected. All prophecies were fulfilled in incredible accuracy. But it's not over yet. Jesus also said that one day He'll be coming in the clouds of heaven with power and great glory, with majesty. He will come victorious. Yes, the first time He came, it was a silent night. But the second time He comes, He will not be silent. Heavens will rejoice. This time, not only a choir of angels, but all the angels from heaven will pierce through the clouds of heaven and receive Jesus. We're all going to welcome in the clouds of heaven. And the most important question today is, are you ready for this? Have you given a chance to give your life to Jesus? So, I want to say a special prayer right now. And I encourage you. Today, if you just came here for the kids, we thank you so much. Your presence was a blessing. But I do not want you to leave this church today with at least giving a chance to Jesus Christ to be born into your heart. So you can have that peace that transcends all understanding. And you can be ready and sure that Jesus will come again and take us home. Let us pray. Father in heaven, we thank you so much for your love and care for us. We thank you for our children, our school, who sang so beautifully. We thank you for the church, our families, our people who are here today. And Lord, in the name of Jesus, we pray your Spirit will touch every single heart in here today. We pray your Spirit will make Jesus to be born into our hearts today. Maybe there's somebody here today who is struggling in life, with issues, struggling with faith, with finances, with health. Maybe the doctors told them the bad news. But in the name of Jesus, we pray your Spirit will bless them and touch them. And Jesus will be born in somebody's heart here today. And when He comes, Lord, I pray that every single person in this room today and our families who are not here, everyone we love, will be ready on that day when you come to take us home. Until that day, help us to hold on to the hope we have. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.